Mattel definitely had some great reveals, including for their Masters of the Universe line. So I want to take a tour through the booth to show you what Mattel had in their Mattel Creations booth at the 2023 San Diego Comic-Con. I figured you all would definitely want to start with Masters of the Universe. And we have this awesome motherboard cutout promoting Masters of the Universe Revolution coming out soon on Netflix. As I've already reviewed on the channel, right under that big cutout, we have her in Masterverse action figure form. Really love the figure and the packaging. This is this year's Comic-Con exclusive. And then to the right of motherboard, we've got our Revolution action figures. We've got the Battle Armor He-Man. We've got Skeletech. So after Skeletor has been infected. And then that arm's kind of a bendy arm, which is awesome. And then we've got Sorceress Teela. She became the Sorceress at the end of Revelation. Not to mess it up. And then Gwildor is going to be a part of this season, which is exciting. Those ears articulate, by the way. And then we have this awesome version of Orko. The Gwildor and Orko are going to be a part of a two-pack, an exclusive two-pack for Entertainment Earth and Big Bad Toy Store. But the other figures will be mainline retail release. And let's come over here to the new Eternia stuff. Pardon me. Excuse me. No worries. So we have the new Masterverse packaging revealed, bringing in a lot more of the artwork to the front, which I think is great. I think it looks fantastic. I'll splice in some footage from Roy Suarez, who described the art at the MOTU toy panel. But I really like the strategy they're taking with this Masterverse packaging. The art was the best part, but it was always on the back or the side, so I love that they brought it here to the front. I think it's way cooler this way. And then for new Masterverse figures, we've got Man-at-Arms, Mechaneck, Triclops, I'm blanking, Triclops, Snoutspout, which are all here on preview night, but then the new one that we saw unveiled at the MOTU toy panel is Trapjaw, which comes with a sword accessory that can pop in there to his arm. And the bottom part of that claw part can actually pop off, and you can add that to the jaw of this trap jaw. So a lot of really cool features with that figure. Then we got the movie Evil-Inn, played by Meg Foster. So that's what's on the outside. Let's go to the inside, which is more Origins focused. So the cartoon collection will be the main retail line this year for the Masters of the Universe Origins. So like last year was Snake Men, this year will be He-Man and the Masters of the Universe, the cartoon collection. So new card backs and newly sculpted bucks for this line. I think the one that was revealed was Beastman at the panel. These are all new bucks for the Filmations or cartoon collection figures. So it's a slimmer build, not as wide of a chest, and they all look really good. And then this is the Diabolical Snake Invasion 4-pack, which we got to see the art for the first time. Pardon me. We got the packaging for Sun Man Rules of the Sun 3-pack, which I think closes out that original vintage line. And then we've got Extendar and Cyclone, which were showcased at the MOTU toy panel. Both action features are intact with these, which is really, really cool. Especially the Cyclone, you can basically pull out his chest a little bit, which will activate the spinning feature, which is great. Fangor, Lady Slither, which I think if you watch the preview night video, that bottom snake tail piece can be used both for the male and female figures. And then we got Night Stalker as well to go along with your Stridor. It's looking awesome. But the vintage line will continue a Mattel creation. So they want to fulfill that promise of getting us all the original vintage figures, and that will continue on Mattel Creations. So there you go. So that is the Masters of the Universe section of the Mattel booth. All right, so Mattel booth. So there's going to be some Jurassic Park, and they've set up their 30th anniversary gates that take you right into seeing the gate. Still up on Mattel Creations, trying to get backed. And seeing it in person, it does look good. Like, I will not deny, I want this gate. I just think it's a little too pricey. So it has the two electrified fences that go off to the side. There is the motorized door opening feature. We've also got the Lost World decoed Bull T-Rex with the improved feet, which looks great. I think they dropped him to be accessible at the 6,000 level. So I think it's been hovering around the 1,500 backer mark, so still has a ways to go, but you never know. I do love this new version of the Brachiosaurus. I think it looks absolutely fantastic. As someone that bought the first version that Mattel did, the articulation was really limited. So I love how they improved the design and even made it look more on model to what we saw in the Jurassic Park film. It looks pretty good. We got some more dinos over here. Some Hammond collection. And the Kenner collection, which this T-Rex is really good. I bought him, I need to do a review on him. He's a really good or well done T-Rex. Got some Lost World. And I love the Raptor transportation box that opened up the Jurassic Park movie. Then we've got the Comic-Con exclusive Steven Spielberg set. I think it's sold out a lot of days. I'm thankful enough to have gotten one. Again, big thanks to Ian for picking that up for me. He got in. All right, we got some Hot Wheels. Their Star Wars ships are great. My boys love them. It's kind of slightly larger scale. Got the Ahsoka ship. Got damage, battle damage ghost, and undamaged ghost.
You twist my words to make it seem like you don't.
Oops, sorry. Pardon me?
Sorry, buddy.
You're good. And we got these little guys, Comic-Con exclusives. And then we've got more of them over here. Racerverse. I will readily admit I'm not a big Hot Wheel guy, but this looks like a lot of fun. So as people are racing, it's gonna do little avatars inside of the car to race, which is pretty cool. You got some Minecraft. The Minecraft fans. My oldest son loves Minecraft. And then you got the WWE sets. I will readily admit, I am not the biggest WWE fan, but I know they're out there, so I will show it for all of you. Coliseum Collection. I guess that's the retro style. We'll take a look. We'll walk around to see that. I was definitely pumped to get this Muhammad Ali set. One of the greatest of all time. So pumped to get that. And then we got some retro style ones. Currently available on Mattel Creations. Then we got some more WWF superstars that utilizes the Motu Origins bucks. This Andre the Giant is sick. Got a hairy chested Hulk Hogan. That's awesome. And then we've got Colosseum Collection, the old school ring, Jake the Snake. See, I know these guys. Most of them, anyway. The Ultimate Edition figures do look really nice. They do a really good job with the head sculpts on these. And then this ring, I don't think backed, but there it is. They're gonna bring it back out. A lot of wrestlers. Lonely Virgil. Right. Uno. They got their own section now. And then we've got Monster High. A lot of Monster High fans. People go nuts for these exclusives. Pardon me? Yeah, the Monster High fans are intense. They put the rest of us collectors to shame. And there you have it. All right, that wraps up the Mattel booth at this year's Comic-Con. A lot of cool stuff. Hope you enjoyed taking this little walkthrough along with me. And definitely check out some of my other walkthroughs that I've done at Comic-Con so far, as well as other Comic-Con content, as well as any other content on the Geek Dad Life channel. Make sure to hit subscribe and the bell so you don't miss it. And until next time, hasta luego and goodbye.